Hello friends, in previous video we have studied various stepper motors. We have studied variable reluctance type stepper motor and permanent magnet stepper motor. In this video we are going to study the characteristic of stepper motor. In case of stepper motor there are basically two characteristics. First is static characteristic and second is dynamic characteristic. Now let us see what is static characteristic. Static characteristic is the characteristic which is shown by the motor when it is in stationary position. It basically consists of torque displacement characteristic, torque current characteristic. Now let us study torque displacement characteristic. Figure shows the torque displacement characteristic. If we see here, the holding torque increases with the displacement up to certain point, but again it gets to zero. This is the torque displacement characteristic. Next is torque current characteristic. Figure shows the torque current characteristic. It is basically characteristic of torque versus the current. Here there are two torques. First is holding torque and second is detent torque. If we see, the torque increases with the value of current. Now let us see what is holding torque and detent torque. Holding torque, it is defined as the maximum value of starting torque which can be applied to the shaft of an excited motor without causing its continuous rotation. Next is detent torque. It is defined as the maximum value of starting torque which can be applied to the shaft of an unexcited motor without causing the continuous rotation. Now let us study the dynamic characteristic. Dynamic characteristics are considered under the running condition of the motor. Figure shows the characteristic. Here on y-axis there is a torque, whereas on x-axis there is a stepping rate. There are the two curves, one that is shown by the blue line and the second which is shown by the red line. Now let us see what is the significance of these curves. First, let us see the curve denoted by blue line. It is called as pull-in torque. Pull-in torque represents the maximum value of the torque at which the motor can start, stop, synchronize or reverse. If we see in this diagram, this blue curve denotes the pull-in torque. At this value, the motor can start, stop, synchronize or reverse up to the maximum pulse rate S1. Now let us see what is this red line. The curve denoted by red line is nothing but pull-out torque. It shows the maximum stepping rate for the various values of load at which motor can start but cannot stop, synchronize or reverse. Here if you see, the red line denotes the curve that is called as pull-out torque. Now here there are the two pulse rates S1 and S2. The motor can operate perfectly up to the curve S1, but its value can be increased from S1 to S2. But if the motor operates at the rate beyond the S2, the motor will lose its synchronism. So if we see here, there is a slew range. Now let us see what is slew range. Slew range basically denotes the area between the two lines, that is a pull-in torque and pull-out torque, in which motor can operate without losing its synchronism. If we see the curve, this area that I have showed with hatched lines denote the slew range. The motor is desired to operate in this slew range. Thank you friends for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ikeda and do subscribe our channel Ikeda. Thank you.